وسلم told them that is very easy. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. That there is no ilah but only Allah. And the word ilah, as I do mention in tafsir time and again, that is either derived from aliha or from walaha. But that is a literal tahqiq and literal research. As far as the case of the word ilah in usage in Holy Quran and Sunnah is concerned, so it means that la ma'buda illallah wa la hakima wa mutasarrifa illallah. That there is no ma'bud to be worshipped but only Allah. And there is no mutasarrif who can do thing and who is doing thing but only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they said that we want to accept it. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them that put one by one your hand in my hand and say la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Now they were the newcomers. So they said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mananna alayka is amanna bika wa saddaqnak. We have done a favor to you because your own people do not believe and we believed in. We put our trust in you. So that is our ihsan and our favor to you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam listened to them. And right at the moment Jibreel Amin came, they put their foundation stone in the proper direction. Sometime we do make compromise or we keep quiet. And later on the bay and the Khalij, that was that we cannot cover it. We cannot hold it later on. So Jibreel Amin came and he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that recite to them Yamun Nuna alayka an aslamu. They say, we have done a favor to you because we accepted Islam. قُلْ لَا تَمُنُّ عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ. Tell them, no, that's not a favor to me. Otherwise, that is very difficult. In such a time, when your own people are against you, so many compromises we are doing at the same time. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, as Allah ordered him, لَا تَمُنُّ عَلَيَّ إِسْلَامَكُمْ. Don't say that you have done any favor to me. بَلِلَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ. Our brother Salah is sitting there. He is Arab. He knows. Sheikh Basim is here. يَمُنُّ. This is فعل مضارع. And فعل مضارع is حقیقت in حال and مجاز in استقبال. One mazhab of Nuhat and grammarian is like this. The other one is that is حقیقت in استقبال and مجاز in حال. But anyhow, فعل مضارع in Arabic language, that is used for two tense or for two times. Number one, the present, and number two, the future. So here, that is for future. بَلِلَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ. Iman is the source of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the reason and basic cause that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be doing favors to you because He blessed you with Iman. So alhamdulillah. Allah has given us Iman. This Iman is a great blessing, even though we came here for enjoy and to entertain. But to the limits of Sharia, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Holy Quran in Surah Al-Qasas, إِنَّ قَارُونَ كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى فَبَغَى عَلَيْهِمْ وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ قَوْمُهُ لَا تَفْرَحْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرِحِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that Korah, who? Korah, in New and Old Testament, his name is Korah, K-O-R-A-H. And this Korah, in our own Urdu language, someone who is blind. So he was blind. Yes, but that is, his name is Korah. In Quran, his name is Qarun. Inna Qaruna kana min qawmi Musa. He was from the cousins of Musa. He was Israeli. Fabagha alayhim. But he got billions of dollars at that time. So his class got changed. As you know, if your own cousin will become millionaire, the moment he will become millionaire, his class will get changed. He will not like to sit with you, the poor guy who's working in 7-Eleven. Yes, he will be sitting with rich people. Class change. So the class of Korah changed for Baga alayhim. Yes, so he was showing his pride to his own people. And Allah says, وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ إِلَى الْقُوَّةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ. That we have given them such a big treasuries that even the keys of his treasury were for a big group of youth guys, they were unable to carry on his keys, even not the treasury. Ma inna mafatihahu plural of miftah, latanu'u bil usba, latasqunu bi jama'a, ulil quwa, the youth people. Is qala lahu qawmuhu la tafrah. His own people told him that, cousin, this is not good to show your pride. Inna Allah la yuhibbul farihin. Allah doesn't like those who are showing their pride. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that his own people, they told him, la tafrah, inna Allah la yuhibbul farihin. Wabtaghi fima ataaka Allahu ad-dar al-akhirah. Whatever Allah has given you. Allah has blessed people with different things. Someone, he has the money, he does not have the health. Another one, he does not have the money, he is healthy and he is feeling good. Yes, so he is blessed in one way, another one, in another way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the same way, he blessed every single individual with such a thing which another person he has been deprived of. So he must pay thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If somebody, his kidneys will stop working, what he will do with millions? If his heart is getting into failure, so he is billionaire, what he will do with the billions? Everybody should think of the favor Allah has done to him personally. And then he will be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is qala lahu qawmuhu la tafrah wabtaghi fima ataaka Allahu ad-dar al-akhirah. Whatever Allah has given you, that's what I told you in Tafsir, wa mimma razaqnahum yunfiqun. Sheikh Basim is here. He said that this ma is mawsul aam. What is this? This is mawsul aam. Whatever we have given you, Allah said, whatever we have given you, you have to spend therefrom. So this is not only relating to money and to wealth, that you have $100, so you have to spend in the cause of Allah $2 therefrom or $5 therefrom. You have thousands of dollars, so you have to give 1,000 in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have health, that's also a blessing of Allah. You have to do sadaqah of your wealth, your health as well. What is your sadaqah if you can help anybody in one way or the other? That is the sadaqah. That is the charity. You have knowledge, you have to give it to someone to convey the message. That is a charity. Yeah. So whatever, you have skill. So if you can help anybody, you have a proper opinion. If you will give that proper opinion in a specific field to someone, that's your charity. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith, وَهِدَايَتُكَ التَّرِيكَ لَقَ صَدَقَ. If somebody will ask you, I want to go to housekeeping, this area is called?
Housekeeping.
Yes, him and Fahim, they were asking the ranger guy. So, yes, I was half sleepy. They were asking for housekeeping. Yes, and as you know, that in Sharia, that slave girl who has been captured in a battlefield or somebody bought it when the slavery was there. Yes, so the very owner, he can keep her without nikah as his wife. She is not called wife, but she can meet her. Yes, she can be get, he can be get children from. Yes, which is called Amma. This girl? Amma. So in Arabic language, yes, there are two words for that. In Sharia, that is concubine. That's what? Concubine. But in Arabia, before that, they used to call it keep. They used to call it what?
Keep.
K-E-E-P. So when they were asking, so I was half sleepy. So I woke up, I said, what are you talking about? We are not here for keeps. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَابْتَغِي فِيمَا أَتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ. Whatever Allah has given you, you should think of your good in the hereafter, not only in this world. Yes. وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Do not forget your due share in this world as well. Enjoy your life. Enjoyment and entertainment, that is not haram, not prohibited. Otherwise, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created such a beautiful world? Yes, the only thing is you have to entertain and enjoy to the limits of Sharia, not to violate and cross over the limits and the bounds of Sharia. Yes, and number two, when you are enjoying, so you have to be thankful to Allah. So Allah has given us this ample opportunity. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, when you get amazed with the tallness of a tree, with the beauty of a mountain, with water or whatever. So Allah, so Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, don't get amazed with the creature, but with the creator. And right at the moment you should say either Subhanallah or MashaAllah or Allahu Akbar. That how great Allah is, look at this mountain. How great Allah is, look at these trees. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khalqihi Muhammad.